Hello everybody, it's ShadGame here, and today I'll be teaching you guys how to make GFX. Now, if you don't know what I mean by GFX, what I mean is making renders of your character. And so basically, they'll look like this if you haven't seen them. This one is a render of a robot, a robot version, and this is actually another render. Basically, like high 4K pictures of a Roblox character or anything. But, now to do this, I need to do some steps. So today I'll be teaching you guys how to make those 4K renders on Roblox. Let's just get right into it. So, first thing that you want to do is, first of all, you need a character. Okay, first of all, you need a avatar. Now, I suggest you to, download a extension from the Chrome Web Store. It's called the Roblox Quick Set Downloader. All I really need to do is, search up on the Chrome Web Store on Roblox Quick Set Downloader. I'll give you a link to the web store so you can search it up. But let's say you don't have Chrome, you can easily use another tutorial of how to copy your avatar and make a model of your avatar. So I'll link another video to another person's channel on how to make those. So yeah. So if you have the extension, you can just go ahead, go to your profile, click on and this Roblox Quick Set Downloader, and you want to go ahead and click on click to edit in studio. So what you want to do is you want to open that file up. Alright, so once you've loaded in, it should look like something like this. Now, if your character had a package, it would come in like some R6. Like, there will be files in here of R15, and the package won't be in the avatar. What you want to do is like simply, right, let's say I use the superhero package. All you really need to do is in models, you can search up superhero package. And then you can just choose a person's superhero package. And there should be the superhero left arm, left leg, or whatever. You wanna press sexual arts and click all them. Then what you wanna do, you want to, in your player, you just wanna go ahead and press enter. And your character should have that in your package. But I'm not gonna do that today. So anyways, let's just go ahead and get on further. So your character, the head and the body should be separated, and the gear too, if your character had a gear, should be separated too. But what you wanna do is you wanna go ahead and simply click on the head, sexual, click one of the, sexual, and click all of the hats. And once you've done that, you just want to go ahead and click on move in the toolbox, or actually in the toolbar, whatever you call this thing, the bar. And then you want to go ahead and make it move over. Make it go over to the to your avatar's body. Once you have put the avatar's head to your character, what you want to do, if you have gear, you can just go ahead and position that, like what I'm about to do. It's gonna put a pose in it. You can put a pose with your avatar too if you want. So once you've done that, you can now this. is the important part. What you want to do is you want to go on your player, select it, and right-click it, and then you want to click on Export Selection. Now, once you export the selection, you should go into your files. Now, it'll save the type as an OBJ or an object model. So, what I suggest you doing is make a new folder and save it in there so you won't get mixed up with your pictures and with your object models or OBJs. So, I suggest doing that, but you can just save it with your photos or anything if you don't care. If it's messed up, but I put my OBJ file in pictures for some reason. I don't know why I do that, but that's what I'm doing. You can put the file name to whatever you want. I'm just gonna name it tutorial. Now what you wanna do is you wanna open up Blender. Now people use Blender in Cinema 4D for this. I'm gonna use Blender for this tutorial. And maybe like later, maybe by the time I make a tutorial, I'll do it on Cinema 4D. Now, I'll leave a link to the download of Blender. And once you've downloaded it, you're just gonna go ahead and open up Blender. Alright, so once you've opened up Blender, you'll be selecting a big cube, square cube. Just want to go ahead and press delete on your keyboard and select delete. Now what you want to do is you want to go ahead and click on file, click on import, and in import you want to go ahead and click on wavefront or OBJ. What you want to do is you want to go into your file where you saved it, and you want to get that file. Click it two times and it should appear. Now, what you want to do to move around, you just want to go ahead and click on view, click on navigation, and click on walk navigation. Well, actually, you want to hover over navigation and then click on walk navigation. And then with walk and navigation, you can just use the WASD keys to move around. Now, once you've got your character will look all gray. What you want to do to get the color is go ahead and where you see this little white sphere thing, you want to click on that. It will be your next object mode. And then you want to go ahead and click on that. You want to go ahead and click on material. Okay, your color back, but the thing is it will be dark. So what you want to do is you want to go over to this little world thing. You want to go ahead and click on all of these. Check them. And then it should have lighting. Now this is a very important part. For shading, you want to go ahead and click on this. And for the outward, it says alpha. Just want to go ahead and click that and click on transparent. This is so that the background will be transparent when you take a photo of it. Now what you want to do is you want to go ahead and click on cameras and click on active camera. You want to go ahead and click on view. Click on navigation. And hover over navigation. Click on walk navigation. You want to go ahead and walk over, walk over to the character, and you can put the camera position on where you want to render your avatar character. I'm going to render him right here. Now what you want to do is you want to go ahead and click on render right here. It should be in cameras, camera section thing, and then you want to go ahead and click on. And then voila. And then voila. And there we have it. You have your 4K image. Now, to save it, you just want to go ahead and click on image. Click on save as image. Go and save it in file. I'm just going to call this tutorial. And whatever you want. And click on save as image. Now to edit it, I'm going to open up paint.net. By the way, Blender and paint.net are all free. You do not have to pay. Now I'll also put in the link to download it. Now, once you have opened up paint.net, you're gonna go ahead and open up your picture. Alright, so here is our avatar. Now to now since we're editing it, let's just go ahead and make a new frame size. And make sure, by the way, make sure maintain aspect ratio is not checked, because it's usually checked for people who just downloaded it. So you just want to go ahead and uncheck the box, and then put the width and height to 512 and press OK. Now there should be this white screen. What you want to do, just go ahead and click on M, or press on M, or click on this, and then click on that, and do this to the other people. Now what you want to do is you want to go ahead and copy this, your avatar, just press Ctrl C, and then go ahead and add a new layer, and keep the canvas size. Now, if your avatar doesn't fit on it, you want to go ahead and click on this, we'll hover over it, and then press shift, and then scale down. So let's put it at that size. Now, let's go ahead and look for a background for this Easter Bunny. This looks good. Let's just go ahead. Well, actually, this looks a little bit better. Though, I guess we can use this. What you want to do is you want to right click it, copy image, go back into paint.net, and press Ctrl V. And then, like last time, same canvas size, scroll it out. Now, let's say the background is a little bit blurry. And you don't like that, you can just go ahead and delete it. And just go ahead and choose a different background, which is bigger. Let's choose this one. Then we copy the image over here. Set it and keep the canvas size. The same thing. And you're scaling it. Okay, now let's add a few more effects. Now let's say we want to add some snow to the picture. Go ahead and search up snow PNG. Let's choose this one. Let's go ahead and copy the image. Go into here. Add another layer, which is above layer 2. SFB, keep the canvas size. Alright, go ahead and scale it like last time. Now, what you want to do is you want to go ahead and click on the properties of that layer. And in the blending, the mode, you just want to go ahead and click on overlay. Now, it may look a little weird, so just want to put the opacity a bit higher. You can just scroll through different modes to see which one looks the best. I like the button. So then it'll look like that. Now let's say you just want a little bit more effects. Let's search up flare. This is good. Go back in. And later. Press F3 just as last time. And go ahead and rotate this. And then you want to go ahead and put a different mode. Let's see which one looks best. I like lighting this, so let's go ahead and move it up. you do that, you can just go ahead and merge all these letters down. Though they might look different, so I don't think so. Alright, so once you're satisfied with how the picture looks like, you can just go ahead and add a new layer. Now what you want to do is you want to go ahead and click on shapes. Make sure this is set to rectangle and put a good size, maybe 4. And put a rectangle. And go ahead and change the color to white. And that looks good. Go ahead and put the opacity down. Yeah, that looks good. Now let's go ahead and add some text. You can use whatever font you like. I'm gonna use a different font that you need to download. If you want, I can just give you the link to, so you can download it, if I can find it. Right. Let's go ahead and put the size up. Mommy. What should we call this? Easter Bunny. Let's call it Easter Bunny. Let's go ahead and below the avatar. Avatar or let's put it above here. Go ahead and make it a little bit smaller. And then just put it behind there. And then you can just go ahead and copy it. Ctrl C. Make a new layer right next to it. Press Ctrl V. Move it ahead. Make it. You can move it. Well, actually, let's just do that. Move it ahead. Put some effects. Go to blurs. Go to Gaussian blur. You can just Gaussian blur up. Maybe like 70. 71. And there it is. That's your picture. How to make ones like these soon, but anyways, for now I'm just sticking with the beginner's tutorial on how to make it. How to make a GFX on beginner's tutorial. And anyways, that's it, guys. Now, if you like this video, and well, actually, let me save this. Now, guys, if you like this video and want more like this, more GFX videos, I would really appreciate it if you would subscribe to me, like, and comment if you want me to do more. And, guys, that's basically it. And so, I guess that's all. So, see you guys.